Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and last week I created my very first Onshape tutorial, hopefully the first of many. I think I called the video something like Onshape Noob Makes a Tutorial, and that's because I'm so new to Onshape and I realize that I'm probably not doing things the best possible way. In fact, I asked all of you to let me know down in the comments if you saw me doing anything wrong. And wow, did I get some very valuable feedback from that. I mean, people were leaving me comments left and right, letting me know some tips and tricks that I could start using in my game. And so I took that wisdom, I went into the lab this weekend and tried to implement some of those strategies, and I thought today I would share with all of you what I learned. Okay, so here I am in Onshape. This was the part that I built during the tutorial. And here we can see the Onshape YouTube channel. And here's the tutorial, Onshape Noob Makes a Tutorial. And so I'm gonna click into that tutorial and then I'm going to go down to the comment section and I'm gonna say sort by, and I'm gonna sort this by newest first. And then I'm just gonna go all the way down to the bottom here and I'm gonna start with the very bottom comment here from Laurent. So I'm just gonna move this over to my second monitor here. Like I said, I'm gonna start at the very bottom. I'm gonna go one comment at a time and I'm gonna address all of this and share with you what I learned over the weekend by reading these awesome comments. So this first one from Laurent says, there's a rib feature for ribs. Okay, this is referencing one of my comments during the video. I could not find the rib command. It's directly in the top toolbar. The sketch plane must be aligned with the rib plane. In your case, just segment and check the extend to part. Okay, cool. So there is a rib command here on this toolbar. It's right here. I don't know why I missed it when I was doing the tutorial last week, but I could not find that rib command for some reason. And so what I ended up doing was shelling this thing and then creating this underside shape here. So the underside circular boss. And then I created this little cross here and then used that to do essentially just a regular extrusion using some contour selection. So let's go back to before that feature and let's try to create a rib. Now in the comment, he said it needs to be aligned with the rib in the plane. So I wonder if that means I have to pick here on this plane, the front plane, and then begin a sketch and then create a line. So I'm gonna go with a line here, like so. And then I'm going to, that looks pretty good actually. I think that's pretty much good to go. So I'm gonna exit that sketch and then I'm gonna go up to the rib tool and I'll say that we're gonna be using this sketch profile. Okay, cool, that worked really easy. This is supposed to be 2 millimeters. Enter to finish that. And what else do you say? Segment, check, extend to part. Okay, so we're gonna go in here, we're gonna say edit that rib, and we're gonna use this option here, extend profiles to part. So I'm gonna hit that one and boom, there we go. We got ourselves a rib. And that rib is parallel to sketch plane. And so if I expand this, oh, normal to sketch plane. Okay, well, I think that's actually what I want. So let me delete that rib. And I'm gonna delete this sketch just because it's not on the right plane. I'm sure I could edit sketch plane, but I'm just gonna kind of start over here. And then I'm going to create a new sketch on this surface. So right mouse button, new sketch. S key line, and I'm gonna wake up the center of this arc and make a line going in this direction. And I'm going to make a line going off of that in this direction, and off of that in this direction, and off of that in this direction. And now I'm going to finish that sketch, go into the rib command, and use the option for, let's pick this entire sketch. This is gonna be normal to sketch plane. Oh yeah, that's gonna be 2, and that's gonna be extend to part, and that is a much more efficient way for me to make that rib. So thank you, Laurent, excellent suggestion, and that takes care of that comment. Very, very nicely done, and that is how you do a rib in Onshape. All right, so let's move on to the next comment here. This is also from Laurent. It says, for mirroring features, the option is in the drop-down menu, the first option in the mirror tool. By default, it's set to part, but you can select features or face. okay, this is going to be very good for me. So what happened to me was I was creating this model. I got to this point of the model and it looks good, you know, as it's shown there. But if I edit this feature, which, you know, I won't edit it. I'll just roll back here and show you what happened. What I was running into was I would click the plane to mirror about, and then I found the mirror command here, but I couldn't just pick these fillets and this extrusion. Like, I just wanted this vertical wall here and then these fillets. And so it was problematic, and I ended up doing a mirror essentially of the whole part and just kind of remerging. It worked this time because the part is perfectly symmetric, but it certainly would not work in other scenarios where the part is not symmetric. So what Laurent is saying is there's an option in the drop-down menu. So let's go edit feature on that mirror. And by default, it's set to part, but you can select features or face. Okay, so here, mirror type. Ah, okay, this is gonna be very, very useful. I thought this was very confusing when I went through this, and this is excellent to know here. So I can change this to feature mirror, or I could change this to face mirror. Okay, cool. So I want this to be feature mirror, and then for my features to mirror, I'm gonna pick this, and I'm gonna pick the fillet, and I'm gonna pick this fillet down here. I love the way the preview in Onshape just updates right away, and you can kind of see the whole thing that's going to end up happening. So, excellent advice. Thank you very much, Laurent. Thank you for that comment. And that is how you mirror just features instead of mirroring the entire part in Onshape. All right, so with that, I'm going to move to the next comment. So this next comment comes from Prasad. And he says, for the mirror command, you can select the feature you want, set it to mirror in the dropdown in the mirror dialog box as its default to part mirror. Okay, cool. Awesome. We just did that one, but I very much appreciate it. Thank you very much, Prasad. That is very, very helpful. Okay, this next one comes from Kickstand, K1CK Stand. And this one says, you can assign a material by right-clicking on part one in the part section in the lower left corner and then choosing assign material. So yes, this was something that I was struggling with when I did the tutorial. In fact, what I ended up doing was making this little mass calculator in Excel because I couldn't figure out how to assign a material. I was not finding the option. And I actually did learn this over the weekend in the Learning Center, which is where you can go to learn all about how to use Onshape, even if you're using the free version. But I didn't know how to do it, and I very much appreciate that kickstand. And so what I was doing was I was just coming down here and saying display mask properties, which is, it's down here in the very corner. There's this little icon here for display mask properties. And I was using that to come up with the volume, and then I was typing that volume into this little mass calculator thingy that I made, and then coming up with 311 for the correct mass. But the better way to do it would be to utilize this material, and we can see here on the print from the challenge video, from the challenge drawing, that the density is 7,800 kilograms per cubic meter. So 7,800 kilograms per cubic meter. The material is called plain carbon steel, but that's a material that's coming from, you know, my library in SolidWorks. It might not be the same in Onshape. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here to the left, and I'm gonna go down to the bottom over here, on the left to right here where this part is on the bottom. Now, of course, I can drag this splitter bar so that everybody can see it who's watching the video. And then I'm gonna right mouse button on the part there, and I'm gonna say assign material. Boom, there we go. And so I can assign a material here. I can either select from the list or more easily I can search. So I'll search for steel, let's say, or maybe carbon steel. Okay, so carbon steel. So we've got carbon steel here at 7,850, essentially 7,850 kilograms per cubic meter. And so I'm gonna assign that and hit the green check mark. And then I'm gonna go down to my mass properties button down here, mass properties. But when I choose that mass properties button, what's gonna happen is I'm going to be measuring the mass of this part, and I'm gonna be slightly off. So the mass is coming out at 323 instead of 311. So that's not what I want. So I'm gonna go back over here. I'm gonna right mouse button. I'm gonna say edit material. And I'm gonna say, I want this to be a custom material, And so that should be 0.0078 in order to match what we've got over here in the print, 7,800 kilograms per cubic meter down here in the print, down in the title block. A lot of times you'll see the material density in your title block. So If you don't have that material in your library, you're going to need to either modify your library, which I'll show in a different video, or you're going to need to make a custom material, 0.0078. That's grams per cubic millimeter, which converts to the correct value when we're looking at kilograms per cubic meter. So with that, we can accept that custom material. We'll call that TTT-plain carbon steel. And again, what I'll do in another video is I'll actually add that to my library so I can use that over and over again. But for now, let's assign that material and then let's go back down to the corner here to our mass properties again and take a look at the mass properties of this part. And when we select this part now, we can see that our mass is showing up as, what, 321. Wonder if this is, let's see here, what are we missing? Oh, I forgot again to roll this bar down to the bottom. I did this during the tutorial also. I'm a little embarrassed that I'm doing it again, but there we go. We can see we roll that down to the bottom. We go into our mass properties. We click on the mass properties here, and boom, now we've got ourselves at 311. So that's exactly what we wanted for that mass, and we are using the correct material now, or the correct density. And that was something I did not know how to do last week. So thank you very much to Kickstand for letting me know how to do that. Again, I did actually learn it in the Learning Center, but I hadn't had a chance to actually apply it until you gave me that tip, and I went in and tried it myself.